So a lot of people have been dissatisfied with the Boruto series, and while I've only seen the anime, I haven't read the manga or whatever it is exactly that they're doing with it. I know it's kind of ahead in some way, shape, or form. I don't really have that much of a problem with it so far. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that this is an amazing series. I'm not saying that it compares to the original. I mean, it's pretty much a spin-off. That's what I call it when I'm trying to explain it to my friends. I don't think it compares to Naruto or Naruto Shippuden in any way, shape, or form. But it never really was supposed to. It's not exactly supposed to be a continuation of the original story or anything. I mean, yes, I know it is. It actually shows the characters that were in the original series and like what they do after the original series ends. But that's not the point. I mean, this is just a way for them to make more money. Like, let's be real, while they are putting a lot of effort into it, while they're not trying to make it just a piece of shit just to make money off of it, that is the whole point of it. If there wasn't some kind of incentive, they wouldn't be doing it. It's not supposed to be just an extended version of Naruto. There's a lot of people complaining that there's just not anything serious going on, like you can't feel any sense of danger at any point of the story, but first of all, in a typical shonen, okay, at least for the main character in the majority of the main cast, you're never really gonna feel any danger for them anyway. None of them usually die. And this really can be said for the majority of Naruto. I mean, not many of the main characters die, at least like the younger ones, you know, in Naruto's generation. Neji dies at the very, very end, like the final arc. But, like, that's what I'm saying. Like, that took, what, a 600 chapters for that to happen? Maybe only 500. Not exactly sure on that. But, like, we're just at the very beginning of Boruto. And I'm not saying that people necessarily even will die, but I don't really know what people were expecting here. This is off of Naruto, and Naruto wasn't really huge into killing off their characters. Yes, they did kill Jiraiya, but that was, like, a huge thing that happened, and even that, like, he just wasn't a part of Naruto's generation or anything like that. And speaking for Boruto specifically, again, I just don't know what people were really expecting here. I mean, if you've seen the entirety of Naruto, which I'm sure you have if you're watching Boruto, then you know, like, the main idea was that Obito's dream kind of was fulfilled, not in the way that he expected, but he kind of did achieve peace since he did make the world unite and have a common enemy. And they kind of just set all their differences aside, and, you know, the idea is once the war is over, that since they defeated that common enemy, they can now be friends. And that's pretty much what happened. I mean, as we can see in Boruto, you know, everyone's kind of in, like, still the Shinobi Alliance. They go from village to village, visiting each other, going on field trips and whatnot. Like, it's pretty much exactly what Naruto wanted to happen, and that's the main idea here. Like, at the start of Naruto, and pretty much up until kind of the very end, like, the last few months or so, Konoha is pretty much at war, at least, like, a Cold War, with every other village, except for the Hidden Sand, which they're kind of in, like, a weird little peace treaty with, but then is just immediately broken anyway. Like, they end up completely betraying them, kind of destroying the Hidden Leaf to some extent. I mean, like, what did people go into the series expecting when there's a full-on alliance between all the main villages? Like, I don't really understand it all. Another interesting thing that a lot of people seem to have a problem with is that Boruto is like this genius compared to Naruto, who was kind of an idiot. I mean, he was shown to not really have that much skill, like he had to work very hard to get as far as he did. But for one thing, that was shown to not really be the case on multiple occasions, okay? Just because he was an idiot and he kind of slacked off when it came to like academics and whatnot, he was actually shown to have a very high aptitude. When he was taught properly, when Kakashi would teach him things, he kind of was stupid about it. He's like, this is really hard. But at the same time, he was able to pick up on things very quickly, so he actually was pretty intelligent when it came to becoming better as a shinobi. And again, that's really not the point anyway. Even if he was a total failure, he had to completely work his ass off to do even the simplest things, I don't see why that would be the case for Boruto, especially knowing that Hinata is his mother. Aside from the fact that Naruto's genes are actually potentially, I would probably argue, even better than Hinata's, let's just, you know, go with the whole thing like, oh, Naruto had to work for everything, he had nothing going for him. So then he's left with his mother's side, which again is actually pretty overpowered, okay? She is a Hyuga, and if anything, she was like supposed to become the head of the main branch. So it would definitely make sense that at least just from her, he would be very naturally talented. He doesn't have a Byakugan as far as we've seen, but he should have, you know, just the basic, like, taijutsu abilities, which happen to be, like, the most powerful thing that the Hyuga have, and they're a very powerful clan within the Leaf. It's shown that they're not nearly as strong as they were built up to be at the beginning of the series, but I would say that they are definitely stronger than the majority of clans from other villages, and at the very beginning, at least, they were built up to be kind of like a rival of the Uchiha, so they definitely have to be worth something. And while amongst his classmates he clearly is a prodigy of some sorts, I don't think it's completely over the top or anything. Like, I don't think that he's any more overpowered compared to his classmates than Sasuke was at the beginning of the series, and it was even shown that people were easily able to catch up to him if they put in the effort, specifically Naruto, not so much other people. I mean, Lee was pretty strong, he was a year ahead too, but like, it's just not completely ridiculous. And something very interesting about this, I know that it happens later in the series, I have not seen this happen yet, but I know that Sasuke ends up actually becoming Boruto's mentor to some extent, so it makes perfect sense, really. Like, he kind of is like Sasuke without all the moodiness and whatnot, having to deal with all the terrible childhood shit. Like, it seems like that is the idea. Like, it's not like they're just making him completely overpowered for no reason, and it's not like he doesn't have his own problems, like things that are holding him back, clearly. We just got past a part where he didn't have any, like, purpose or anything, so even though he had talent, he's like, oh, you know, I don't really know what I want to do, but it always works out in the end. And this was shown to backfire on him. He wasn't able to just do that and then be able to take on tough challenges as a shinobi. He had to learn, he had to live with purpose. And that's what he did, and now he's fine. Like, he was able to learn from his mistakes. Just because he's overpowered with, like, ninjutsu and whatnot, taijutsu, that doesn't mean that as a person, he is. And you need to be that in the Naruto universe. I mean, to be completely honest, if Boruto was kind of a joke, just like a little shitter like Naruto was at the beginning, I don't really think I would enjoy the series at all. Like, I'd be sitting here like, whoa, so we're just watching Naruto again from the beginning, just with maybe slightly better animation? I mean, why would anyone even want to see that? Just go rewatch Naruto. I want to see a totally different series. I want to see a character who starts the complete opposite. He's like Sasuke. It's kind of like we're watching Naruto from Sasuke's perspective, again, without, like, the whole backstory shit. Like, he has completely different motivations. But, like, we get to see a little bit of a prodigy. And he's not a complete asshole about it like Sasuke was. He's actually a really nice kid. Despite, you know, the problems he has with his dad, you know, a lot of people don't like that he treats Naruto shitty. I'll get into that in a second. But, like, he actually really enjoys the presence of all of his classmates. He's completely devastated by the fact that they might be separated in the future. So, I really don't understand why people dislike this about him so much. And so, possibly the last big thing I'm going to be talking about here, and something that I don't really like either, but I don't think that it's unbelievable, and I completely understand what they're trying to do, and, like, I feel like it's something you're actually supposed to hate. And I'm talking about, like I was saying I'd mentioned earlier, about how he doesn't really like Naruto so much, his own dad. And, like, I understand why people are against this so much, and even I don't like it so much when I see it, but I think that's the point. Like, I think that's the feeling we're supposed to get, because, you know, we know Naruto is this complete badass. He always wants to do things for the good of others. But, like, Boruto is just a 12-year-old kid. He might even be 11 at the start of the series. I think he's 12, though. Like, how do you think you would feel in his position, really? I mean, he works his ass off at all times. Well, he doesn't really work his ass off. He's kind of lazy, but he is a prodigy, okay? He is really good at what he does, what his parents want him to become. He's really good at it. And even though his mom's obviously really good about it, he doesn't really get much attention from his dad just because he's the 7th Hokage. He's always busy doing all this shit. Like, as far as he's known, no one's ever really been at war since he's been alive, so he doesn't really understand the concept of war. He doesn't understand what Naruto's doing, how he's keeping all this stuff in check, how he's keeping possible catastrophes from occurring in the future, like Kaguya coming back or some other bullshit. I know some crazy stuff happens in the movie. I haven't really seen it, but I've seen parts of it on YouTube. I mean, he's trying to prevent all this stuff from happening, but Boruto doesn't really understand the magnitude of what he accomplished in the Great War and whatnot. Like, he doesn't get it, and I don't know why people would expect him to. He's just a little kid. And really, this is clearly going to be one of the biggest problems he has. Like, this is something he has to overcome. He's gonna have to learn to understand his father's perspective, okay? He's clearly not going to be like this for the rest of his life. This is just something he's going through as a little kid, and he'll understand, and he'll probably even feel like an idiot later in the future. I mean, just based off the opening scene, okay, where he's, like, facing off against that Kawaki guy. I don't really know what's all about that. I don't know if we actually know anything about that guy. But that seems pretty serious. He seems to be dead serious as a shinobi. clearly his dad is out of the picture in some way, shape, or form. If Naruto was there, he would kick that guy's ass. Okay, that just goes without saying. So he's definitely going to be very remorseful of how he thought of his father in the past, and he's going to be like, damn, I understand now that he knew that something like this was going to happen. That's why he was always working his ass off to protect the village. And it's going to make perfect sense why he was like that. Like, it's going to be great character development. Why do people complain about how he's a super big prodigy? Like, oh man, you know, he has no problems. He's just a super good kid. He's just the perfect character. But then, when he has some kind of actual issue, people complain about, like, oh man, why is he such an idiot? Why does he hate Naruto so much? Like, well, you have to pick a side, you know? You can't just complain about every single thing about this guy's character. But so, yeah, I think that's all the main problems that people have with this series, at least as far as I've heard. I don't think it's that bad at all. Okay, like, the way I went into this, okay, when I heard that Boruto was going to become a thing, I was like, oh, jeez, all right, like, Naruto, you know, it's just going to be one big filler. I mean, it kind of is one big filler, but, like, it's just going to be one big filler. I'm probably not even going to watch it, you know, whatever. And then it came around, and I'm like, eh, you know, I haven't seen Naruto in some time. I'll see what it's about. Like, I'll give it a try. It is a spinoff of Naruto. It's, like, the first anime that I actually got into, and that's, like, why I'm here now. So I'm like, you know what? Okay. I'll give it a shot. And I had pretty low expectations for it, and it turned out it wasn't that bad. Like, I mean, why do people think this is going to be the greatest series of all time? I don't know. I thought it would be pretty bad, actually, and it turns out it's fine. It's not like I have, you know, have some serious dedication to it or anything. I just watch 20 minutes of it a week, and it's nice. You know, on Wednesday, I'm like, oh, cool, there's a Boruto episode out. Nice. I'm happy that it's not completely about the old generation. They're showing all the new characters and how they're similar to their parents and how they're different. And I'm really happy in the small times that I do get to see the old generation. They don't overdo it. We just get to see them once in a while. It's really exciting when we do see how they've grown up. I think it's well done. Like, I don't really see any huge problems with it. I don't expect it to be this super serious series. I don't expect it to be like Naruto. I expect it to be its own thing, and that's what it seems to have become. So with that all being said, don't hate on Boruto, okay? It is what it is. Maybe give it another shot if you've completely given up on it. Just don't expect it to be the greatest thing ever, and maybe you'll kind of enjoy it. If you enjoyed this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Remember to leave me a comment letting me know what you thought about this video, ideas for future videos you'd like to see, different animes you'd like me to get into, different manga and whatnot, different series you'd like me to be talking about on Fridays. I hope you guys are hyped for the Sunday video because I think it's going to be a good one. I hope you guys have an excellent day, an excellent start of your weekend, and I'll talk to you guys on Sunday.